So what is gel electrophoresis? Gel electrophoresis. Let's imagine that we have a bunch of different fragments of DNA. And let's say that we've got a small fragment, a bigger fragment, an even bigger fragment, and then one even like just a giant fragment of DNA. Well, let's say that I wanted to separate these different DNA fragments based on size. I want to separate them based on size. So size separation. Well, we know that DNA is negatively charged. So what we're able to do is we're able to take advantage of this negative charge, and through a process known as gel electrophoresis, we're able to separate DNA fragments based on size. So let's imagine that we take a gel. So it's this rectangular gel, and up here we add the DNA fragments. So there are different wells at the top of the gel. And let's say that we add this fragment here, this one over here, this fragment over here, and then this big fragment over here to this well. And let's say that we put a charge on this gel. So let's say that we added a negative charge over here at the top and a positive charge over here at the bottom. Well, we know that DNA is negatively charged, so when we actually turn on the electricity, when we create the electrical field, the DNA is going to start to migrate over here to this side of the gel. So the smallest piece of DNA is going to migrate the furthest because it's just so small. And this medium piece of DNA is going to migrate a little bit, not as far, and then the giant piece of DNA is going to move just a little bit. So this is the general principle of gel electrophoresis. We add DNA fragments at the top of the gel, we add an electrical charge. And then the fragments migrate down the gel towards the positive charge, and the smaller fragments migrate the furthest. Now, what we want to do is we want to be able to quickly look at the gel and determine what the approximate size of each fragment is. So, in order to do that, we're going to run something known as a DNA ladder. So, let's imagine that I took this gel and made it a little bit wider. And in this well over here, I added something known as a DNA ladder. So I'm going to add a DNA ladder. And what this DNA ladder is, it's a predetermined set of DNA fragments. So someone actually went through and actually figured out what the exact size of each fragment is. So when we run the ladder, there are different size fragments of DNA. And we know exactly what size each fragment is. So we know that there's going to be a fragment over here, for example, maybe one over here, maybe one here, one here, one here, and then one over here. And since we have this ladder and we know exactly what size each fragment is, we're able to guess the approximate size of our fragments, the ones that we added over here to these wells. So we're able to guess approximately what the size of this fragment is, since we already have we know what the size of this DNA fragment is.
So what we have here are a bunch of wells. So each column basically. So let's look at this column. This is one column, and for example, here's another column. So basically what we did is we added DNA over here. So you take DNA and you just add it to a bunch of wells at the top of each column. And there's a charge. So there's a negative charge here and a positive charge here. And after you add the DNA, it'll start migrating because it's repelled by the negative charge, it'll start moving down. Now you end up with this gel and you see all these different bands. Well, these bands represent the different DNA fragments. And these strips over here at the right and left corner of the gel are the DNA ladders. So this is DNA, it's a DNA ladder. And basically what that means is that you've already predetermined the exact size of each one of these marks. So let's say that you know that size, you know this size, and you know that this piece of DNA is a lot smaller than this piece of DNA. So smallest to largest. And based on these ladders, you're able to estimate the size of the DNA fragment. So you can approximate that this fragment right here is approximately the same size as this fragment over here. And you already know the size of this fragment. So that's the concept behind gel electrophoresis. It basically allows you to separate DNA fragments based on size by applying an electrical charge to this gel.